Hey, I'm Jonathan Mintz. I'm the lead designer on Disney Fantasia Music Evolve at Harmonix.
Let's start by talking about what's new when it comes to E3 2014 and Fantasia.
So a lot of what we're showing off this year for the first time, we're introducing the narrative to the world. So we spent a long time introducing players to the game. This is kind of a whole new way to interact with music. And so we wanted to welcome players into the Fantasia realm, have some callbacks to the original, let them become the new Sorcerer's Apprentice, and meet Scout, a former apprentice who helps the player discover some new musical magic. So it's a good way to help players actually learn how to play this whole new style of game, and also gives the player sort of some goals and progression to really like bring them into the experience and discover all the musical potential there. We're also showing off multiplayer, which basically allows two players to go head-to-head in sort of a dueling conductor style, where the better you do in each section, the more opportunities you're going to have to steer the mixes to your own style. And the if you work together, you can open up our composition spells and basically record solos as a team.
Let's start by talking about the story, which you're finally unveiling. Talk about Scout and kind of where this fits in with the whole Fantasia films.
Totally. So as fans of Fantasia will recall from the original Sorcerer's Apprentice, apprentices of Yen Sid tend to be a little bit ambitious. They like to get ahead of themselves. So Scout very much like falls into that mold. She's a former apprentice who was really excited trying to find all this these new ways to bring in music, to discover remixes, and bring them into the worlds of Fantasia. But working with her, things go a little bit awry, as again they tend to do for apprentices. And so you and Scout will wind up working together, finding ways to use those new spells, to use remixes, to use composition spells, to push back this force called the Noise that is basically disrupting the music of Fantasia. And the two of you have to find a way to stop that.
You guys also have incorporated Yen Sid. What's his role in the game?
So when you enter Fantasia for the first time, you're going to meet Yen Sid. You will take on the role of the new Sorcerer's Apprentice. You're going to have the opportunity to sort of earn the legendary hat that Mickey stole, but you'll actually have to put in some practice to learn how to perform music and earn that. And then using some of the power and the skill that Yen Sid teaches you, that'll eventually give you the opportunity to help Scout further on your journey.
Will there be any type of Mickey cameo in this game?
There may be some appearances from the famous Mouse himself. Lots of apprentices have studied under Yen Sid over the years, and he is definitely the most famous, so we want to make sure we pay tribute to that.
When it comes to the new neighborhood, talk a little about that world and what the inspiration was.
Totally. So for all of our realms, we looked at which songs we wanted to bring into the space. So the neighborhood is the home of The Who's The Real Me, CeeLo Green's Forget You, MIA's Galang. And so they've got sort of like this very like upbeat, intense style. We sort of felt like there was like kind of an overall like urban feel to it. So we took that and sort of explored that artistically. We took a lot of inspiration from kind of street art, graffiti. And so as the player enters the space, it starts out a little bit quiet. And as they bring the music of those songs into the realm, they're gonna like paint the walls with art, touch that art to bring it to life. There's, you know, this fish mural that you can actually cause the fish to leap off of the wall. There's all sorts of strange stuff that goes on in that space. There's an abstract painting on a billboard that you get to enter and sequence some MIA to. So it basically allowed us to play with that music in a visual style that we felt sort of captured and was true to the spirit of the songs that we put in that space.
Now you even have a vegetable beatbox. Talk a little about that.
So yeah, one of my favorite interactive hotspots in the game is when you play CeeLo Green's Forget You. After that, you kind of open up this subway stop that you can visit. You dive down into that. You can choose a meat band, which is known as the Cool Cuts, or a veggie band known as the Beatboxers. And the player basically discovers these characters at the subway stop, learns how to kind of sequence their animation and their musical performances, gets to record their own song with these three different characters in each band, and then when they return to the realm, those characters actually appear on a train and will start riding around the city singing your composition back to you.